Hello, 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 and welcome to Fortress! No, not Team Fortress. A Game Boy Advance game called Fortress. Very deceptive, isn't it? Yes, it is. Now, this is basically Fortress. It's, as you can see, pretty much like Tetris. With a twist, you get to battle. And by battle, I mean have a bunch of crappy AI turrets that randomly shoot and, like, nowhere near your enemy's base. But, you know, that's alright. They get what you get, right? Anyways, as you first see, that's what a turret looks like, or what the turret looks like in a space stage. Pretty much what I've been playing for the past few rounds is called Tournament Mode. There's about three modes to this. Battle, which is pretty much a single battle which you pick from any stage in the game. Prehistoric, Medieval, Pirate, and Space. Yeah, pretty much all that. That's all that is. And, in Blitz, you basically, there's no wait time. Right now, what you can see is that there's a little clock above the screen right there. It's called the wait clock. It's basically before the turrets start blowing all your shit up. You have that amount of time to build it. And pretty much the whole bad thing about the clock is that if you can pretty much whip your opponent's ass within the 10, 30, 40 seconds that you, start building within the clock, you can pretty much win the whole thing every time. So, the clock is about to end in a few seconds, and right about now. Yep, and it's time now. Start battling. Come on. There, battle. And we're off. Fighting, shooting, missing the opponent's base utterly. There is, like, from time to time you get, like, bonus turrets or whatever that you can control that shoots, like, a random suicide bomber onto your enemy's base, but usually that doesn't work at all, and it pretty much fails every single time. So, Blitz, okay, as I started explaining, is pretty much the battle without the wait clock, and Tournament is basically you play through every single stage in the game in, I think, order. I can't really remember, or I didn't pay attention. Either one. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Sometimes random creatures will come and try to destroy your crab, which is really stupid. Because personally, I've never gotten a random creature happen on my base. Only it happened to me, and it takes me off. Many people, you'd probably notice that I'm pretty much winning this without any sweat at all. Like, without any actual, you know, what do you call it? Skill involved. Yeah, let's go with that. Pretty much, this whole entire game consists of this. Tetris. That's it. Tetris. What? Wait, what is this? Why, it's one of those random creatures I told you about, if I could get it. If I could somehow pan the camera down. But yeah, that's pretty much one of them. What is it? Randomly walk across your screen. I don't think... Oh, yeah, there you go. You did something. What a dick. Pretty much, yeah. Okay, that was really annoying loud. Okay. Bet that screwed up my voice. Anyways. Whole game. Tetris. And, on harder difficulties, the computer will either demolish you within the first 30 seconds, or you'll slowly burn out and... Oh. Hell. Happened again. Yeah, this game has major shading issues, too, with some of the sprites. Like... Sometimes you'll think it's an area you're putting it down is solid, or like it's a building and it blows up. And I pretty much screwed myself over here. But think I can work it out. I'm clever. I'm a smart male. I can figure it out. What's the worst that could happen? And suddenly, in Hiroshima. Oh man. For now, let's just enjoy this wonderfully composed music. Did I mention this is earlier GBA? This is like made within the first year I do believe that the GBA came out. Back when Nintendo Power still had a Nintendo Power Advanced version. With all your Game Boy Advance news, because Nintendo totally thought that their Nintendo GBA was going to be the next big thing. They were pretty much right. Paved the way for the old Nintendo DS. Yep. That Ooh, suicide bomb. Fantastic, right? Ah, so violent sounding. God. Anybody who's never played this game, this looks so nerdy. And it is. That's why we call it lesser known games. That's the whole point. This one game really never got any advertisements on TV or any mainstream coverage. And really wasn't known by anybody, mostly due to, well, the fact that this game sucked some awful. I'm not playing it because it's good, I'm playing because it's lesser known. Or, well, yeah. Majestica Studios is probably, is why it's there. Oh, see, that was the bonus bomb. And now I'm shooting my own suicide bomber over there. Take that, Dirka Dirka Mahab Jihad. And I should be winning this in a couple of seconds, as I do believe the cap, point cap to this game is 12,000. And there we go. I win. As soon as it tallies up or registers that I have won. Ah, there we go. And now we get to bomb the hell out of their base. Victory bombing. Yep. That is the, that's your reward. You get to see their hard work and all those innocent people get bombed to hell. Ain't it grand? And then all the nice screams of death. Yay, Green Wings Tournament. That's pretty much all you get. And these retarded credits. Yep, that's it. That's all you get for completing the game. No sex scene, no epic final cutscene. Nothing. Well, I hope you enjoyed this really, probably really, really boring show of games. If you like this and would like to subscribe, feel free. Hit the old yellow button right next to my name. Come on, please. Yeah, well, I'm not gonna beg for you bitches. Later, assholes.